This is an obstetrical scan at 17 weeks gestational age. Now, first thing to note in this scan is a complete full baby, but head is not visualized properly. You can see there is no calvarium or no skull above the eyes. Both of the fetal eyes are visualized. These are also called frog's eye. Note, the fetal brain is floating outside. Now this is very important to visualize to differentiate it from severe microcephaly or amniotic band syndrome. This is a case of anencephaly, and in more severe case there can be multiple other fetal abnormalities. In ultrasound, many times fetal brain is not properly visualized due to lack of space between fetus and maternal myometrial wall. So in this case, try to view in multiple positions and multiple angles. So there is change in position of fetus and proper visualization of fetal head above eyes. Anencephaly is a common severe congenital condition in which fetal skull and parts of the brain are missing, leaving the brain tissue that forms exposed and floating outside. This is a lethal condition and baby cannot live after birth. So the early diagnosis is very important to abort the baby timely. Otherwise, if pregnancy continues, this becomes a great stress and pain for the mother. The baby can die before delivery or after birth. Sometimes requires C-section of mother for delivery. Now these congenital conditions that affect brain, spinal cord and nerves are called neural tube defects. Anencephaly is a common neural tube defect, and about 1 in every 4,600 babies born with it. When pregnancy starts, baby's brain and spine starts to form as a flat disc of cells. This flat disc rolls into a tube-like structure called the neural tube. About 28 to 32 days after conception, the neural tube is completely formed. When part of the neural tube does not close completely, there is an opening called neural tube defect. Anencephaly is so common that it makes up about half of all cases of neural tube defects. Now, risk factors include genetics and environmental factors. These not run in families, but if you have one child with neural tube defect, you are more likely to have a child with anencephaly. The risk factors that you can control are folic acid deficiency before or during the pregnancy, high heat exposure during pregnancy, for example high grade fever or hot tub bath, patients who are overweight or obesity, or uncontrolled diabetes before pregnancy have higher chances of having a baby with anencephaly or other neural tube defects. Medications that treat seizures, migraines, all illegal addictive drugs can cause neural tube defects. So you can control these risk factors, especially if you have previous child with neural tube defect. Take at least 400 micrograms of folic acid before and during the pregnancy. Try to stop all the medications. Control diabetes, overweight and obesity before pregnancy, and try to live a simple life.